A very good afternoon to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. This is Rajiv Kohli and today I am going to show you that how you can create this Minecraft Vending Man animation in PowerPoint 2016. And as you can see that we have three main objects on the screen, one Vending Man and two trees, which the tree goes behind the man when they get close to it, and the man is moving its left and right legs, and the head of the object is also spinning here. So let me show you all the objects that I have used in this presentation. From the home tab, click the select drop down button and then click selection pane, and here you can see all the objects that I have drawn here to create this complete scene here. First we have the face, and to draw the face, as you can see that the rectangle shape has been used. Let me show you by ungrouping all these objects. From the format tab, after selecting the object from the format tab, click the group drop down button and then choose ungroup, and you can see all the objects here. Use control and the middle mouse button to zoom in and zoom out. And as you can see that I have mostly used the rounded corner rectangle here to create the Vending Man. And same way to create the tree, I have also used the rounded corner rectangle shape. So let me undo all of this. So the selection pane really helps you to identify all the objects, and you can easily select the objects by just clicking the object name in the selection pane, and you can also move the shapes up and down just like you use the bring forward or send backward commands. So let me show you the animations that I have used in this presentation. These are the animation which I have used to create this animation scene here, and I will teach you that which animation I have used to create this entire scene. So let me delete all of these by selecting the first one, then holding the shift key, then select the last one and then hit the delete key from your keyboard. Okay, let me close this animation pane. So here we have the head first, and as you can see that it is already tilted to 5 degrees, I think. Let me show you by right clicking on the face and then choose format shape. And here you need to click on size and properties. And here you can see that I have already rotated the face to 5 degrees. So the first animation we will apply on the head, and that will be the spin animation. From the animations tab, click the add animation drop down button and choose spin. Set it to play with previous and open the animation pane, and the timing of this animation will be 1 second. Open the effect option window by double clicking on the effect, or you can also open it by right clicking on the effect and choose effect options. And here you need to specify the degree to which you want to rotate the head, and I will use 10 degree counterclockwise rotation. So as the head is already rotated to 5 degree clockwise, so the 10 degree counterclockwise will also tilt the head to 5 degree to the left. So I don't need any smoothness here and want to auto reverse this effect as well, because I want the head to reverse back to its original location where it was before. So in the timing tab, you need to set this animation to repeat until end of the slide and hit the OK button. So here we have our first animation. Now we are going to move to left hand. So as you can see that I am zooming in, then it is zooming, not properly zooming to a particular object here, because none of the objects in the slide has been selected. So if I select the left hand and now use the control and middle mouse button to zoom in, then it will automatically zoom to the selected object. So for the left hand, we are going to use grow shrink effect. Start it with previous and the duration will be 1 second. Now open the effect option. So here I will apply 50% grow and shrink effect with only vertical grow or shrink, and want to auto reverse this effect, and also want to repeat it until end of the slide. Hit the OK button. So here you can see that the hand is shrinking and reversing back to its original size. Now what I am going to do, I want this left hand to move a little bit up when shrinking. And so for that, I am going to apply motion paths. Go to the add animation drop down button and click more motion paths, and here apply the up motion path. Hit the OK button and then adjust the length of the path. As you can see, that is always the problem in PowerPoint when you try to adjust the motion path. If you are defining a very short path, then it always jump, the ending word always jump to the start point, and you have to do it very carefully. I think that much will be enough here, and set it to play it with previous with the duration of 1 second. And I also don't want any smoothness for this effect as well. Want to auto reverse this effect, and also want to repeat this until end of the slide. Hit the OK button. Now let me show you both of these effects in the slideshow. I think that is fine here. Now we are moving to the right hand. So same effect will be applied on the right hand with a little bit delay between the animations. So what I am going to do, I will select the left hand and will click the animation painter once, and then click on the right hand. And what you only need to do here is to add the delay timing, and I will add a 1 second delay for the right hand. Let me show you the preview. Okay, that's fine. And we are going to repeat the same animations for the legs as well. So first of all, I am going to apply the same animation to the left leg by using the animation painter. That's fine. What I only need to change here is the gross shrink rate, and instead of 50%, I will use 75% for the legs. Hit the OK button. And I would also like to add a 1 second delay here for the left leg. Let's see the preview. As you can see that the left leg is shrinking when the right hand is shrinking. So they should match. For the right leg, I will use the reverse order. Select the left leg, click the animation painter, and then click on the right leg. And you don't need to apply any delay here, because I want the right leg to shrink when the left hand shrink. So I think these animations are working fine here. So let's move to the trees. And for trees, we are also going to use motion paths. Click the add animation drop down button, choose more motion paths. And here I am going to use diagonal upright. Hit the OK button and adjust the path length. And I will move that part in the middle of the head, and want to play it with previous with their duration of around, let's say, 10 seconds. So I need to start the tree motion smoothly, but want to end it very fast. So I will only apply the smoothness to the start with a 5 second duration. And don't want to auto reverse this effect. I don't want the tree to come back from the behind of the character. Instead, I will only apply repeat until end of the slide, and hit the OK button. Let me show you the slideshow. As you can see that after finishing the animation once, it will start from the beginning and will repeat the same path again. And here I need to apply another animation to this tree, and that is grow shrink as well. Start it with previous with the duration of the same amount as the motion path, that is 10 seconds. Open the effect option window and set it to shrink to the teeny size, that is 25%, without any smoothness. And want to repeat until end of the slide. Hit the OK button. Let me show you the slideshow. As you can see that the tree is moving behind the character and shrinking as well. And both of these animations will repeat until end of the slide. So we are going to do the same for the tree number 2. Select the tree number 1 and click the animation painter. And then click on tree number 2. And just add a delay timing. And I would like to add a delay of 3 seconds here. Oh, and here we have the final screenshot. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. You can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.